Now I'm going to show you how these translation tables work. So I'm going to define a variable called table that's using the string.makeTrans function, which makes a translation table. And I'm going to translate from the characters A, B, C to 1, 2, 3. And I can give any number of characters here, the characters I want to replace, and the ones I want to replace them with. And I should say that this is using the string module, so somewhere we have to say import string before we start doing any of this. You only have to do that import once, of course. Now I'm going to define a formula F to be simple formula A plus B equals C. And then I'm going to call the translate method of the formula F and pass it this translation table. And that will evaluate to the string 1 plus 2 equals 3. So it's taken each of the elements in the table, and they correspond A to 1, B to 2, C to 3, substituted those into F, and given me back a brand new string. And now, if I go ahead and evaluate F.translate of table, which is 1 plus 2 equals 3, then that will give me the result true, because 1 plus 2 is 3, and that's a legal Python expression. Now, what I want you to do is to define for me the function valid, which takes a filled-in formula, like 1 plus 2 equals 3, filled-in formula F, and returns true or false, true if the formula is in fact valid, if it represents a true equation like this, and false if it represents an invalid equation, like 1 plus 3 equals 3, or it should also return false if it represents an error, like 1 divided by 0 equals 3. That wouldn't return true or false, that would signal an error, and I want you to handle that within the code for valid. And I'll give you a hint, which is you should consider using a try statement. So try do something, and then you can say accept zero division error something. So what that does is it executes the main body, in which you can test if evaluating this expression F is true or not, and return appropriately. But if evaluating the expression F causes a zero division error, then this clause will catch it, and then you can do the appropriate thing here. You should also think about if there's anything else that can go wrong within the execution of valid. Here's my version of the solution. So in defining valid, takes a filled-in formula F, and it's going to return true. The main part is if we evaluate F, and if that's true, then we should return true. But I also had to check for the zero division error, and even to be a little bit more sure here, I ended up checking for arithmetic error, which is a superclass of zero division error. It covers a few additional things, like overflow of really big numbers. You didn't have to do that. It would have been fine to just catch the zero division error. And if there is such an error, then you should return false. But I did one more thing here, and it looks kind of complicated. So I'm using a regular expression search, and let's look at exactly what's going on in this confusing part of the clause here.